Okay, to begin work with your DASIE, you will need to make an incision in the middle of the DASIE, such as this, to expose all of the various layers of the DASIE itself. And I'm going to use a rat tooth forceps here to help identify a few of the layers. For instance, you will be using this white layer here as the skin layer. And then this will be an expanded subcutaneous layer. And then you can see deep within the surrogate abdominal cavity, you can see intestinal contents that we'll talk about in just a second. One unique characteristic of the DASIE is that it has these little red latex strands that are facsimiles of vessels. And so to correctly grasp a vessel, for instance, with a curved Kelly forceps, you would take the skin edge, roll it out, and then push and grasp that little red blood vessel, and then put it to the side, such as that. And so you can actually practice with the DASIE, tying around a hemostatic forceps using kind of a good facsimile of a blood vessel. So those are the layers of the DASIE, but you'll need to make it a liberal incision in order to expose enough of the layers of the DASIE to perform your suture patterns. Inside the abdominal cavity of the DASIE is the facsimile of the bowel. And you can see now I'm pulling the bowel from the abdominal cavity. What you'll need to do to practice your inverting patterns and your patterns designed for viscera is to pull some of the pink intestine out, and then you'll be using the intestine for patterns such as the Lambert, the Cushing, the Connell, in patterns such as that are designed specifically for viscera. Obviously, you'll need to make an incision in the viscera as well, and so we can go ahead and do that here, and you can make it slightly longer using your curved Mayo scissors, such as I'm doing here now. And so, while you could practice all of those suture patterns on the skin portion of the DASIE, the problem is with that skin portion is you're not going to be able to invert them like you will on the intestinal portion of the DASIE. And so I would urge you to use that for the suture patterns designed for viscera.